Today I'm going to install a variable motor on my RCP20 print processor. The motor and the water pump are both fitted on a tensioning plate. I've already removed the belt between the motor and the shaft. I'm going to remove all the tubes inside because they look like they're all going to start leaking pretty soon. I'm removing the tensioning plate from the processor and disconnecting all the electric cables. I will be using a 919D series DC motor with a gearbox ratio of 148:1. All that linked to a 30mm diameter gear with 20 teeth. I also use the speed controller that I found on Amazon. That's the dimensions to drill the holes for the new motor. It's now mounted on a 3D printed part, available on my Thingiverse page linked below. The polarity should be checked for the motor to turn in the right direction. I'm connecting the motor to the speed controller. After the controller is wired to a 12 volt transformer used for LED lights, which will be connected to the old motor cable. I'm now starting to reinstall everything on the tensioning plate. I have not installed the speed controller on the plate yet because some of the electrical connectors need to be bolted from the other side. I fitted some metal stud under the controller to lift it from the plate and the electrical connectors. I'm drilling a hole at a convenient place next to the other controls. I am tightening the tension plate down while applying a small amount of pressure on it to tighten the belt. I'm now fitting the rubber tubes to the water pump. I didn't use this pump in the end because it didn't have any suction. I replaced it with a small 12-volt diaphragm pump, which is wired to the 12-volt transformer. At top speed, the paper can pass through the development tank in about 40 seconds. It's now possible to use it for RA4 and black and white processes. If you need it to go even faster, you can choose a different gearbox ratio for the motor or use a 15-volt transformer. It's also quieter than the original motor and pump.